السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. طبعا نقول مبارك عليكم العشر الأواخر، لأن الحمد لله بفضله وتعالى احنا في أواخر رمضان، أيام فضيلة إن شاء الله الله يعودها على الجميع بالصحة وبالعافية. يسعدني جدا وجودي معاكم اليوم، وأشكر جميع يعني اللي ساهموا على أساس أنه دائما يوصلون معلومة للقطاع الصحي ونفيد الجميع بإذن الرحمن. فإذا صوتي واضح أتوقع، فاليوم إذا إحنا يعني الموضوع عن التيم بيلدينج، طبعا الموضوع اللي يعني اخترته بعناية، لأن دائما إحنا لما نشكل أي فريق عمل تصير عندنا بعض اللبس، من هم الممبرز اللي we need to bring to this group or to this team. هل هناك أي معايير معينة we need to choose to make this team يعني perform our goal exactly or not. هنا طبعا تكمن نظرة leadership. Leader, he's the one who should be able to collect the right team members and to make them have a good relationship with each other, to complete each other. وهذه النقطة اللي احنا راح نتعرف عليها اليوم، إنه to complete each other. طيب احنا هنا راح ناخذ the small introduction about teams and what is teams, what is a group. Teams more than just a group. They are people who come together to fulfill a specific purpose. You have a purpose, you have a goal. That's why you brought some people to help you achieve this purpose. Teams may be ongoing or they may be formed for a specific time limit objectives. يعني ممكن التيم هذا يستمر على طول السنة، أو إن التيم هذا يكون مجرد فريق عمل for short period. Once the mission accomplished, the team will be disappeared. مثلاً زي blue code team، هذولي دائماً موجودين. We always need blue code team. Other projects, maybe we need a team for temporal time, and after that we don't need that team anymore once العمل نفسه accomplished. Okay. So there are some definitions. وإحنا نركز على definitions اللي موجودة هنا بالألوان. A team is a small number of people. طبعاً it is very important that we bring small number of people to make them more focus on the work, not to bring everybody. So a team is a small number of people with complementary skills who are committed to a common purpose performance goals and approach for which they hold themselves accountable. التيم هذا أو الأعضاء هذول they have to have skills. لازم أنا أجيب كل واحد عنده مهارة معينة، كل مهارة تكمل المهارة الأخرى، ما أجيبهم having the same skills. كل واحد من الأعضاء لابد أن يتميز بمهارة معينة ويكون عندهم high accountable. They are accountable to this task. يعني ملتزمين التزام كامل بالعمل اللي هم جو يشتغلون عليه. So a team is more than, نكمل the definitions, a team is more than purposeful than a group, which is an aggregate of individuals who interact, mutually influence each other. وهذه النقطة، إن أنا يكون عندي تيم فيه تربطهم علاقة جداً وثيقة مع بعض بحيث إنهم يأثرون على بعض. يعني أنا عندي مهارة معينة، مثلاً أنا عندي مهارة الداتا أناليسز، شخص آخر عنده مهارة البرزنتيشن أو الإلقاء، العضو الثاني عنده مثلاً مهارة الداتا كوليكشن، لازم نكون نكمل بعض، لازم نعرف إيش المهارات اللي تكمل بعض عشان نقدر ننجز المهمة بشكل صحيح ونأثر على بعض بشكل جداً إيجابي. طبعاً team building، لما أنا أجي أتكلم عن how I'm going to build this team، هو عبارة عن group development techniques هو عبارة عن technical things that focus on task and relationship aspects of a group's functioning in order to build team cohesiveness. يعني أنا عندي task, التيم هذا must focus on the same task, لازم الواحد يكون عنده نفس الانترست, نفس الجول, وهم تربطهم العلاقة مع بعضهم بعض ومع التيم مع الجول نفسه. طيب نشوف هنا, نكمل نشوف how to form the team. How we can form the team. عندنا 6 steps to form the team. موجودين معي, بارك الله فيكم.
Yeah, we are all here.
Okay. And you can hear me very well, right?
I guess so.
Okay. Okay. So the team, when we form the team, we need to consider 6 steps. The first step is about forming. يعني I'm the leader now thinking how I'm going to form this team. So هنا the initial stage of the group development is which individual assemble into well-defined team. عارفة وإيش الجول بالضبط وعارفة مين الأعضاء اللي أبغاهم to be in this team to be able to accomplish. I have to be very clear about this one. For example, I have 3 nurses, social workers, physicians, I have respiratory therapist, case manager, hospital administrators. I need those people in the ethics committee, for example. And I have to define why I need each one of them to be in this committee, what their role would be. And are they going to help and to be important or not? Okay, the second step is storming. Let's talk about storming. Storming, usually, you need to consider and understand smoothly. When you have members, definitely, in the first couple of days, there will be kind of competitions and conflict. Then everyone might have different interests or different view or different understanding. Or maybe they will have kind of experience to influence. I have more experience, that means I can give more or I can explain more. Norming is the third step, and norming is define their goals and rules of behavior. شوفوا احنا يعني الاشياء اللي قاعدين نستخدمها او المفردات relationships behavior, لانها هي مش, it's not just about task, it's not just about مهمة or mission to be accomplished. Those members need also to have good behavior to work with each other and also to have a good relationship to meet the goal. So that's why they need to define the goal with each other and the role of the behavior that they need to deal with each other, how they going to deal with each other. For example, يعني حطيت هنا example. Okay. أنا حطيت مثلا هنا example, إن إحنا مثلا في الإثكس كوميتي نكمل معاها, ممكن رح نتفق, is there any certain cases that we need to see? Or is there any philosophical or guideline that we need to develop to work with each other? هذا لازم يكون عن طريق الاتفاق بين الممبرز. Okay. step number 4 is performing. شوفوا احنا لسه مع هذا كله ما وصلنا الى to perform anything. يعني بدينا الفورمينج، بدينا الستورمينج، وبعدين بدينا النورمينج، الان بدينا مرحله البرفورمينج. عشان كذا الليدر دائما لازم يكون عنده تصور بان انا مش from day one or from the first week I'm going to bring this team، معناها ان they will be effective and they will produce a kind of results. I have to understand الستبس اللي هم راح يمرون فيها. فوصلنا هنا لمرحلة البرفورمينج، هنا صار مرحلة الأجريمنت among الممبرز. الممبرز هم نفسهم هم اللي لازم يكون في بينهم اتفاق وتفهم about what is the role that needs to be done وhow it will be carried out. مش أنا as a leader I'm the one who needs to tell member number one what to do and member number two what to do. They must be able to walk with each other and from this perspective. Okay. عندنا الآن step number 5 اللي هو adjourning. The team dissolves after achieving its objectives. And let's become a permanent. يعني احنا سوينا performing وخلصنا المهمة أو results اللي حنا نبغاها. After that, we may consider, do we need this team for another purpose? Or should we reform this team again to do another task? Or خلاص نتفق إن انتهت مهمتهم إلى هذا. في فيديو أنا حابة أوريكم إياها إن إحنا كيف نتعلم من العمل مع بعض كفريق. القصة أكيد إحنا يعني we all know the history of the rabbit and the tortoise. لما يسمون السلحفات والأرنب، هم عندهم كانت رسالة أو قصة قديمة بأن مين اللي راح يكسب، ودائما السلحفاة هي اللي كسبت مع أنها هي البطيئة، وهذا بسبب البيهيفير اللي كان حق الأرنب. لكن اليوم تغيرت القصة هذه when it comes to the team building. الرابط عنده skills والسلحفة عندها skills. They both should complete each other. واثنينهم المفروض انهم to win the race. فنشوف الفيديو اذا في مجال. في مجال نشوف الفيديو دكتورة عبد الله.
I'm just trying to upload this for you.
Okay. طبعا ان تعلمنا من القصة.
Once upon a time, a turtle and a rabbit had an argument about who was faster. They decided to settle the argument with a race. The turtle and the rabbit both agreed on a route and started off the race. The rabbit shot ahead.
Both of us needs to win. عشان كذا الممبرز أول لقاء بيننا وبينهم لازم نفهمهم إن you all need to win this project.
Play the video now.
Okay.
And ran briskly for some time. Then, seeing he was far ahead of the turtle, he thought he'd sit under a tree for some time and relax before continuing the race. He sat under the tree and soon fell asleep. The turtle, plodding on, overtook him and soon finished the race, emerging as the undisputed champ. The rabbit woke up and realized that he'd lost the race. The moral of the story is that slow and steady wins the race. This is the version of the story that we've all grown up with. But our version of the story continues. The rabbit was disappointed at losing the race, and he did some thinking. He realized that he'd lost the race only because he had been overconfident, careless, and lax. If he had not taken things for granted, there's no way the turtle could have beaten him. So, He challenged the turtle to another race. The turtle agreed. This time, the rabbit went all out and ran without stopping from start to finish. He won by several miles. The moral of the story? Fast and consistent will always beat the slow and steady. It's good to be slow and steady, but it's better to be fast and reliable. But the story doesn't end here. The turtle did some thinking this.
In the same time, I need a member who can also fast in achieving things, think quickly, accept things in a very optimistic and easy way. ولكن مش معناها all of them needs to have this kind of behavior or habit.
This time, and realized that there's no way he can beat the rabbit in a race the way it was currently formatted. He thought for a while, and then challenged the rabbit to another race, but on a slightly different route. The rabbit agreed. The turtle and rabbit started off. In keeping with his self-made commitment to be consistently fast, the rabbit took off and ran at top speed until he came to a broad river. The finishing line was a couple of kilometers on the other side of the river. The rabbit sat there, wondering what to do. In the meantime, the turtle trundled along, got into the river, swam to the opposite bank, continued walking, and finished the race.
Anyone from the audience has any questions to Dr. Ameera? في أي دكتورة أميرة؟ هل في سؤال للدكتورة أميرة من الحضور؟ ممكن تكتبوه على الشات.
عشان نكسب وقت لحد ما ينزل الفيديو أو يحمل.
ما في سؤال الآن يا دكتورة فـ we can continue. تبغاني أكمل الفيديو؟
تحب نخلي الفيديو في الأخير ولحد ما ينزل ونكمل البرزنتيشن؟
That's fine.
أو إذا هو باقي له شوي وينزل we can. أوكي. طبعًا إحنا راح نعرض الفيديو في الأخير and we will discuss it with each other. في certain behaviors I have to address it clearly to my members or to the member who's going to be in a certain team. It is very important that each member in this team have a clear understanding about the purpose of the team or of the project or why he or she joining the team. They need to know this, and you as a leader need to make sure every one of them knows exactly what is the purpose of this teamwork. Assist teams competitions. وهذه راح توضح لنا أكثر في الفيديو لما نشوفها. هنا أنا لما أجلس مع each team لازم أخلي each one of them to define for me what is his weaknesses and strengths. أنا as a leader ممكن أعرف من خلال خبرتي معاهم أو شغلي معاهم ولكن المفروض أن كل واحد منهم able to say what is his strength and what is his weaknesses. Once they are able to do that ال competitions أو اللي بينهم ممكن يصير أقل حدة وكل واحد يعرف والله أنا تنقصني الخبرة في هذا المجال ففلان ممكن هو يكمل ما ينقصني وهنا إحنا we are start to build good behavior and good relationships among the team. عشان كذا assess the team's competitions is very important. إذا واحد من التيمز unable to tell you what is his weaknesses, this person has a problem. لأن no one is perfect, no one knows everybody. That's why we need to make sure that each one is able to address his weaknesses and his strengths. بعدين عندنا هنا نقطة ثلاثة, which is very important. Use effective communication strategies. When we talk, or when we discuss, or when we even chat with each other, we need to put things clearly, even in verbal communication or in written communication. في ناس تستوعب كذا يعني تاخذها بسرعة once يعني they hear things. وناس no, they need to listen to it, they need to think of it, and they need to put it down, to write it. فما نعتمد على one way of communication, يعني اجتماع ونجلس ونتناقش and that's it. No, we need to discuss verbally, we need even to discuss in written, and also we need to repeat or recite what we have agreed on or what we have discussed. عندنا رقم هنا أربعة, allow members actively participate in team's work. دائما في team work, you need to know and understand you as a leader, and you want to have kind of a production. That means you need to make your members involved and participate and think loudly with you. And also they need to provide attention and discussion, not just to listen to one person who is the leader. No, they need to be part of every single discussion and ideas. بعدين هنا have a clear plan of proceeding. احنا اتفقنا الان على الجول, او الممبرز اتفقوا على الجول, but how now you're going to perform the goal. لازم يكون في clear plan to perform this goal. All the members need to set this plan. يعني هم يحطون لنا الخطة نفسها. وأنا as a leader, I'll discuss it with them why they want this plan to be done in this way. بعدين continuously evaluate and assess the team and the work. الناس حطت goal وحطت plan, ولكن أنا ما أترك الموضوع كذا. No, I have to keep evaluating from day one, من أول خطوة وأنا أقيم. ما ننتظر التقييم يصير للنهاية بعدين نشوف إن إحنا we need to repeat everything from the beginning. No, نقيم خطوة بخطوة عشان إذا في شيء مش ماشي صح من الأول we need to correct it from the beginning. طيب المفروض إحنا نتكلم عن الفونكشنز, ولكن مش عارف هذا الفيديو نقدر نستخدمه الآن.
شور.
Okay.
In keeping with his self-made commitment to be consistently fast, the rabbit took off and ran it.
I'll fast forward this, Doctor, until the till where you want me to stop and then let me know.
طيب. هو إن شاء الله يعني ينزل, يعني إذا هو نزل يعني عشان ما أعطلكم يعني. فإذا هو نزل الفيديو إحنا we can just go ahead.
Okay. Did some thinking, self-made commitment to be consistently fast. The rabbit took off and ran at top speed.
شايفين انتم كلكم الفيديو انا شغال عندي. Can you all watch the video now? Thank you.
Can you all watch the video?
There's no way the turtle could have beaten him. In keeping with his self-made commitment to be consistently fast,
دكتور عبد الله تسمعني صح؟
Yes, I hear you, but please don't click on the video yourself because you're gonna make it stop. It's working.
Okay. But now you can.
The rabbit
watch the
took
video,
off
right?
and ran at top speed until he came to a broad river. The finishing line was a couple of kilometers on the other side of the river. The rabbit sat there, wondering what to do. In the meantime, the turtle trundled along, got into the river, swam to the opposite bank, continued walking, and finished the race. The moral of the story? First, identify your core competency, and then change the playing field to suit your core competency. The story still hasn't ended. The turtle and rabbit by this time had become pretty good friends, and they did some thinking together. Both realized that the last race could have been run much better. So, the turtle and rabbit decided to do the last race again, but to run as a team this time. They started off, and this time the rabbit carried the turtle till the riverbank. There, the turtle took over and swam across with the rabbit on his back. On the opposite bank, the rabbit again carried the turtle, and they reached the finishing line together. Both the turtle and rabbit felt a greater sense of satisfaction than they'd felt earlier. The moral of the story? It's good to be individually brilliant and to have strong core competencies, but unless you're able to work in a team and harness each other's core competencies, you'll always perform below par because there will always be situations at which you'll do poorly and someone else does well. Teamwork is mainly about situational
Okay. So did you all watch the video now? Nkemmel?
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay, so everybody watched the video, right? شفنا ايش كان الهدف من الفيديو؟ ايش كان الهدف من الفيديو؟ ان في التيم ورك there is always win-win. It must be win-win situation. يعني وما في competitions between the members. For me as a leader, I have to be very sure that I'm not bringing people to compete. I'm bringing people to influence each other, and their skills and competencies should accomplish each other skills and competencies. لأن كل واحد عنده مهارة وخبرة مختلفة عن الثانية. Okay, sorry, I need to go back. Okay, now, let's go to these slides. Let's go to these slides. Here we have function role for team members. Function هي هنا ما لها علاقة بالproject. هي لها علاقة how I'm going to organize role of the team within the project نفسها. ما لها علاقة بالproject. هي لها علاقة بالإيش بالأدوار اللي راح يلعبها كل واحد أو الأدوار اللي راح ينفذها كل شخص. For example, certain roles needs to be defined مع أي project, مع أي عمل, مع teamwork. For example, عندي أنا شخص يكون إيش؟ Creator. The person who gets the ball rolling, supplies, ideas, and initiatives. فأنا هنا لما أكون فريق عملي عارفة إن أنا عندي شخص عند الخبرة بأن دائما bring new ideas, put ideas together, think out of the box. This is important member to be with the team, to have this kind of function. عندي شخص member ثاني يكون هو إيش الكوردينيتور اللي ينسق. في ناس عندها مهارة عالية في التنسيق to coordinate things, وناس they don't know how to coordinate things, but they have competencies in other things. For example, coordinator, the person who is able to see the project as a whole. أنا يمكن as a member أشوفها من الزاوية اللي تخصني. في أعضاء ثانية تشوف الممبر البروجكت from different perspective and they help us how to analyze and accomplish this mission. فالcoordinator always the person who is able to see the project as a whole and can bring together a variety resource to keep the project moving forward. So very important to have this kind of function with the teamwork. Mobilizer, the person who keep as other team members energized and moving forward, help provide a spark, specifically in difficult or challenging times. يعني احنا في التيم وورك حقنا لازم يكون عندنا شخص very positive, عنده very positive attitude, not negative. Or not disappointing others, or not criticizing others. دائما لما احنا نقول والله صعب المشروع هذا ما نقدر ننفذه هو يبحث لنا حلول. No, we were able to move it. دائما يحط لنا ايش some of the hope that we are able to do things. احنا نسميه هذا دائما ايش المobilizer. Let's see also the functions. Recorder. عشان كذا احنا حكينا لما we communicate with each other we need to communicate in different way. That's why whatever we do with the teamwork we need to record every single thing. So لازم يكون عندي من الممبرز اللي عنده كذا الهنت to record everything that we discussed, that we planned, that we sit together. فالمهارة هذه ضرورية ان تكون في احدى اعضاء teamwork. What else we have? Information giver and seeking. في ناس عندها مهارة عالية في literature review. يقول لك مثلا آخر بحث قال كذا. WHO released report. عنده اطلاع عالي. In addition, we need attention breaker. أو ممكن أنا as a leader أكون attention breaker. شخص دائما يحاول إيش؟ يعني أحيانا يصير في خلاف وجهات النظر، أحيانا يصير في مشادة، أحيانا تصير نسبة الكومبيتيشنز عالية، ففي شخص دائما يسوي لنا بريك، سواء كان عن طريق humor of sense, listening and discussing others ما له علاقة بالبروجكت عشان يخفف التنشن، يخلي الفوكس حقنا in a different way. وهذا دائما أنا أنصح إن الليدر of the teamwork هو اللي دائما يلعب الرول هذا او الفانكشن هذا انه هو دائما يكون التنشن بريكر ما يكون هو الشخص اللي يحط تنشن على التيم. This is very important. طيب في اشياء بالعكس ممكن تخرب لي الشغل كامل حق التيم وتحط عليهم جهد اكثر من جهد البروجكت and they might be also unable to work healthy with each other. على سبيل المثال the criticisms يعني كل ما شخص قدم شيء أعطيناه نقد هذا مش كويس هذا ما ينفع هذا مش لا أنا مفروض as a leader أكون كذا ولا أجيب أي member عنده الكاركتر هذا أو الصفة هذه وأنا عرفته إن this is his behavior. ما أجيب شخص يكون passive. أحياناً إحنا طبعاً أكيد كلنا مرينا فيها يعني نكون كفريق عمل في شخص باسيف أو موجود معنا ولكن doesn't like to be involved in anything ما يحب يسوي شيء يحب بس يكون موجود في الفريق doesn't like to give ideas doesn't like to take tasks doesn't like to perform anything بس يجي فالناس اللي يعني passive هذولي دائما I have to keep them away from any project or from any teamwork لأنهم هم أصلا they cannot work with a team they cannot work with a team. عندنا detailers الشخص اللي يحب التفصيل أو أحيانا يكون كويس ولكن لازم يكون لها limitation. If I'm going to bring this person to this teamwork I have to be able to control it. أو إذا أنا as a leader فيني الصفة هذه I have to control it. أحياناً يعني التفاصيل تضيع الوقت. يعني لما الواحد يقول أنا قدرت أحصل على داتا معينة من المكان المعين كيف؟ قال لي 1, 2, 3, 4 خلاص يكفي. No need in it to ask about the details how and when and where ممكن تصير كذا ممكن فالتفاصيل أحياناً تكون obstacles وتكون مزعجة للعمل. لا أنا as a leader I should ask for ولا يكون شخص معي موجود وأتركه كذا. I have to control it. وإذا أنا as a leader أحب الديتيلز ممكن أخذ واحد من الممبرز وأجلس معاه بعدين أنا وهو ويعطيني تفاصيل معينة. في عندنا طبعاً الدومينانت في ناس فيها صفة إنها هي likes to control the whole team حتى لو هو مش leader. هو من ضمن الفريق العمل ولكن likes to control وأكيد يعني we all experience this. فin this way we need to be able to avoid having this member with the team لأنه هو ما يقدر يشتغل مع team. He always like to dominate the team. وأنا as a leader I shouldn't have this kind of behavior when I work with the team. أنا أتمنى أن الخطوات هذه واضحة. طيب أنا كذا وصلت لنهاية البرزنتيشن عن التيم وورك وحبيت صراحة أشدد أكثر وأركز أكثر على كيف إحنا نبني تيم with effective performance ويكون strong enough to achieve the competencies أو المشن اللي أنا أبغاها يكون strong with certain competencies. فالآن إذا حضراتكم عندكم أي سؤال فأم very happy to listen to your questions.
دكتورة أميرة, thank you very much. This is one of the presentations that I think is very crucial for managers, leaders, supervisors, and even front staff, frontline staff. I think it's just quite valuable presentation. Thank you so much, and we're very glad really to have attended this presentation. Very breathtaking. Thank you. Now the floor is open for questions. So if you have any questions, just please put them on the chat, and Dr. Ameera will be more than happy to answer them. Any questions to Dr. Ameera? You can type them in the chat. Questions? Doctor, I think, you know,
yes.
Doctor Jum'a is asking a question and saying, is there a different role of team leader during different stages?
Of course, definitely. عشان كذا حنا حطينا from the beginning, when we form the team itself, six steps هذه حق الforming. طبعا أنا أول يوم أو أول أسبوع أجلس مع التيم I have a different role when it comes to the end of the function of the team. From the beginning I have to be, my role should be a very selective, a good listener, understand how they are communicating with each other, and also able to monitor the behavior and able to make them accomplish each other. Once احنا وصلنا لمرحلة النورمينج, مرحلة النورمينج هم بدأوا الآن إيش? To agree on things. Here when they agree on things, my role or my function will be different. So if you agreed, this is يعني this is the goal and this is the role of behavior that you're gonna يعني work on, معناها اني انا راح احاسبهم عليها. This is my evaluation that I need to build on in the future. يعني هنا الان ابدا اقيم كل شيء على الجول وعلى الرولز اللي هم اتفقوا عليه. فانا هنا ابدا اصير في مرحله الايفالويتر. انتوا حطيتوا الجول وانتوا حطيتوا الرولز وهكذا. Once they performed الشغل أو they carried out and they made the performance, هنا الآن أنا دوري إني إيش to see the results, فعلاً meeting the goals اللي حنا حطيناه ولا لا. ف definitely أنا يكون عندي different role with different stage of step of performing the teamwork.
Okay, that's great. It sounds that even Dr. Juma is happy with the answer.
Oh,
he missed the presentation. Any other questions from the audience? Any further questions?
جزاكم الله خير. أنا سعيدة إني أشوفكم. You are happy.
Welcome to the audience. You can see in the sticky note up there, there is a link for the attendance certificate. I have here from Hamza Abdelghani. Dr. Abdelghani is asking, I remember selected a skill, but he is always destructive. What to do?
Okay.
He's a member, but the member is destructive. What to do?
Yes, this is very excellent question. هو طبعا أنا دائما لما أجلس مع فريق العمل أو حتى مع الليدرز عندنا دائما أقول لهم هو ما في إنسان ولا في يعني موظف perfect. احيانا في شخص عنده مهارات جدا عاليه وانا احتاجها, ولكن الشخص هذا عنده في شيء من البيهافير مثل ما حضرتك حكيت ديستركتيف. هو طبعه كذا, يعني this is his personal attitude. ولكن هو ينجز لي ويعطيني كميه كويسه من الشغل مثل ما انا احتاجها. عنده مهارات عاليه ممكن في اشياء كثيره. انا الشخص هذا once I need him to be with me, I have to set a plan how I'm going to control this person. Not to control him, وهو يشتغل to control the attitude أو behavior اللي أنا ما أحبه منه, اللي هو destructive. يعني دائماً أخليه هو آخر شخص يتكلم, ما أعطيه فرصة إنه يقاطع الناس. أحط مثلاً ست, كل واحد عنده only 5 minutes to answer questions, ولا مثلاً to pose questions or to discuss things, وهو من ضمنهم عنده only this 5 minutes. أسوي عليه كنترول على الاتيتيود أو على البيهيفير نفسه, على البيرسونال بيهيفير نفسه, أسوي عليها كنترول. ودائماً يكون عندي فاسيليتيتر هو يتحكم في الأمور هذه كلها, يحط لي 1 minute 2 minutes, يسوي لي كنترول على بعض الديسكشن ليفلز. فدائماً شخص ممكن يكون عنده سلوك أنا ما يعني ما يناسب جو العمل, ولكن هو عنده مهارات عالية. ممكن هو أناليست ممتاز, statistician excellent, فما أقدر أقول ما أحتاجه أو ما أبغى. No, I bring him, ولكن أسوي control على الأشياء اللي ما أحبها في البيهيفير أو في الاتيتيود. وأتمنى أكون وصلت الفكرة كويس.
Very clear.
Yeah. طبعا هو رابط الفيديو موجود في اليوتيوب, ولكن اكيد الدكتور راح يحطها لكم. انا الفيديو هذا ايضا يعني دائما استخدمها في مرحله اولى, اول ما التقي في اول يوم التقي فيها مع الممبرز. دائما اقول لهم انا ما ابغى someone to compete anyone, انا ابغى اعرف مين يكمل مين, ونبغى نوصل في الاخير زي 2-1. ما أبغى somebody to win and someone to stay behind. فالفيديو هذا يعطينا مسج جديدة إن الحياة أو العمل it's not just one person to win or not فريق واحد to win. We all should win.
Fantastic. As Manal is saying here that the whole lecture and everything will be posted in our social media and our YouTube channel, so you can find it there. Any further questions to Dr. Ameera? This is.
وأنا تشرفت جدا بوجودي معاكم اليوم, وأتمنى إن كان يعني حوارنا اليوم كان جدا مفيد للجميع, وزي ما احنا نقول بالعامية يعني سامحونا على القصور. وأشكر جدا جدا دكتور عبد الله والأستاذة منال، ما قصروا وجزاهم الله خير، وإن شاء الله في ميزان حسناتهم.
الله يبارك فيك، شكرا جزيلا، وشكرا جزيلا للحضور. إن شاء الله مداكم تأخذون الرابط اللي موجود على الستيكي نوت وأيضا موجود في الشات، تأخذوه على أساس تنزلوا شهادات الحضور. مرة أخرى يعني نشكر الدكتورة أميرة على المحاضرة الرائعة. We're very really thankful to you, Dr. Munira, for this great lecture. And also we thank you all for attending. جزاكم الله خير. And we came to the end of our webinar. See you, inshallah, after Eid, and we will have further webinars. Please don't forget to come to our website, www.saudiedublad.org. Ms. Manal has posted in the chat. Please apply as a member and enjoy free learning. And inshallah, يعني, we will see you بإذن الله after Eid, and we will have more free lectures and webinars and workshops, inshallah, that are conducted virtually to cover the five themes of our workshop, our website. Thank you very much, and see you then. كتب الله أجركم جميعا. شكرا جزيلا.
شكرا جزيلا.